Hi everyone, I welcome you all for this Nursing Wisdom channel. Today we are going to see about OBG MCQ for Nursing Competitive Exams. First question, a postpartum patient was in labor for 32 hours and had ruptured membranes for 24 hours. Which of the following condition is expected in this client? Option A, endometriosis. Option B, endometritis. Option C, pelvic thrombophlebitis. Option D, salpingitis. Endometriosis. Endometriosis is a condition where tissue similar to the lining of the womb starts to grow in other places, such as the ovaries and fallopian tubes. Endometriosis can affect women of any age. Endometritis. Endometritis is an inflammatory condition of the lining of the uterus and is usually due to an infection. Predisposing conditions include prolonged rupture of the membranes and delivery, internal fetal monitoring, prolonged labor, cesarean delivery, repeated digital examination, retention of placental fragments in the uterus, postpartum hemorrhage, colonization of the lower genital tract, anemia, bacterial vaginosis, young maternal age. Pelvic thrombophlebitis. Pelvic thrombophlebitis, also known as suppurative pelvic thrombophlebitis, is a rare postpartum complication which consists of a persistent postpartum fever that is not responsive to broad-spectrum antibiotics, in which pelvic infection leads to infection of the vein wall and intimal damage leading to thrombogenesis in the ovarian veins. The thrombus is then invaded by microorganisms. Ascending infection causes 99% of postpartum septic pelvic thrombophlebitis. Salpingitis. Salpingitis is inflammation of the fallopian tubes caused by bacterial infection. Common causes of salpingitis include sexually transmitted diseases such as gonorrhea and chlamydia. Salpingitis is a common cause of female infertility because it can damage the fallopian tube. So here the answer is option B, endometritis, because prolonged labor and rupture of membrane will cause endometritis. Next question, what is the proportionate weight of the placenta to the baby at a time? Option A, 1:2. Option B, 1:4. Option C, 1:6. Option D, 1:8. Placenta. The human placenta is discoid, hemochorial, weight about 500 gram. The proportion to the weight of the baby being roughly 1:6 at a time. Development begins at 6th week and is completed by 12th week. So here the answer is option C, 1:6. Next question, umbilical cord is attached to option A, fetal surface of placenta, option B, maternal surface of placenta, option C, near to the center of the surface, option D, both A and C. Umbilical cord is attached to fetal surface and is attached to center. It is about 40 cm in length, usually vary from 30 to 100 cm. So here the answer is option D, both A and C. Next question, following are the methods of induction of labor except option A, artificial rupture of membrane, option B, methergine, option C, oxytocin, option D, prostaglandin. Methods of induction of labor. Medical methods includes prostaglandins, oxytocin, mifepristone. Surgical methods include artificial rupture of membranes, stripping the membranes. So here the answer is option B, methergine. Next question, Maternal alpha-fetoprotein level is 30 nanogram per ml. Which among the following condition may present in fetus? Option A, meningocele. Option B, meningomyelocele. Option C, both A and B. Option D, Down syndrome. Alpha-fetoprotein, normal AFB is 38 to 45 nanogram per ml. If the value is less than 38, then risk for Down syndrome and Klinefelter syndrome and other chromosomal abnormality. Increased AFB indicate risk for neural tube defect. So here the answer is option D, Down syndrome. Next question. During routine prenatal visit, a pregnant client reports hot band. To minimize her discomfort, nurse should include which suggestion in the plan of care? Option A, drink more citrus juice. Option B, eat small frequent meals. Option C, limit fluid intake sharply. Option D, take sodium bicarbonate. How to treat hot band during pregnancy? Eat less but more often. Sleep on your left side. Consume apple cider vinegar. Sip on water. Elevate the head of your bed. Drink ginger tea. So here the answer is option B. Eat small frequent meals. Next question. Go through the following statement regarding amniotic fluid and find out incorrect statement. Option A. Liquor amni surrounds fetus everywhere except at its attachment with body stock. Option B. Amniotic fluid is completely changed and replaced every 3 hours. Option C. At a time, amount of amniotic fluid is 1000 to 1500 ml. Option D. Amniotic fluid is colorless and near term it becomes pale straw colored. The facts about amniotic fluid. Detected first around 8 weeks of pregnancy, formed partially from mom's side of membranes and rest from baby, its volume keeps varying. At 38 weeks, it's about 1 liter and later decreases to around 700 ml. At term, baby's urination contributes to around 500 ml daily. It is completely changed and replaced every 3 hours at a rate of 300 to 400 ml per hour, provides cushioning, maintains temperature and allows baby to move freely. First option is Liquor amni surrounds fetus everywhere except at its attachment with body stalk. This is correct statement. Next option is amniotic fluid is completely changed and replaced every 3 hours. This is also correct statement. Next option is at a term amount of amniotic fluid is 1000 to 1500 ml. This is not correct statement because at a term amniotic fluid is 700 ml. Next option is amniotic fluid is colorless and near term it becomes pale straw colored. This option is also correct statement. So here the incorrect statement is option C. So here the answer is option C. At term amount of amniotic fluid is 1000 to 1500 ml. Next question is amniotic fluid index is measured by option A, abdominal girth, option B, ultrasonography, option C, Leopold maneuver, option D, ballotment. Amniotic fluid index. Amniotic fluid index is measured with the help of ultrasonography by dividing the abdomen into 4 quadrant. For dividing the abdomen into 4 quadrant, linea nigra is considered as vertical point and umbilicus is considered as horizontal point. In each quadrant, deepest pocket is measured in centimeter. Sum of all pocket is considered as amniotic fluid index. Normal value of amniotic fluid index varies from 8 to 18 cm. Amniotic fluid index less than 5 to 6 cm is considered as oligohydramnios. Amniotic fluid index more than 20 to 24 cm is considered as polyhydramnios. So here the answer is option B, ultrasonography. Next question, only immunoglobulin which can cross the placenta is option A, IgA, option B, IgM, option C, IgG, option D, IgE. IgG antibodies can pass through the human placenta, thereby providing protection to the fetus in utero. So here the answer is option C, IgG. Next question. After determining that a pregnant client is Rh negative, gynecologist orders an indirect comb test. What is the purpose of performing this test in a pregnant client? Option A, to determine the fetal blood Rh factor. Option B, to determine the maternal blood Rh factor. Option C, to detect maternal antibodies against fetal Rh negative factor. Option D, to detect maternal antibodies against fetal Rh positive factor. Indirect comb test. This test is performed to detect presence of Rh antibodies or other antibodies in patient serum in case of following. To check whether an Rh negative woman married to Rh positive husband has developed anti-Rh antibodies. Antibody may be produced in the blood of any Rh negative person by exposure to D antigen by transfusion of Rh positive blood, pregnancy if infant is Rh positive, abortion of Rh positive fetus. So here the answer is option D, to detect maternal antibodies against fetal Rh positive factor. Next question, umbilical cord contain option A, 2 artery plus 2 vein, option B, 2 artery plus 1 vein, option C, 2 vein plus 1 artery, option D, 1 artery plus 1 vein. Umbilical cord contains 2 artery and 1 vein. So here the answer is option B, 2 artery plus 1 vein. Next question, in fetal circulation, deoxygenated blood is present in option A, umbilical artery, option B, umbilical vein, option C, pulmonary artery, option D, all the above. Umbilical cord. The umbilical cord has three blood vessels traveling through it. The largest one is the umbilical vein, which transports blood with oxygen and nutrients into the fetus. The other two are the umbilical arteries, which branch off of the iliac arteries in the fetus and take spent, that means wastes and CO2, blood back into the mother via the placenta. So here the answer is option A, umbilical artery. Next question, gonadotropin releasing hormone stimulates the release of option A, follicle stimulating hormone, option B, luteinizing hormone, option C, growth hormone, option D, both A and B. Gonadotropin releasing hormone stimulate the release of follicle stimulating hormone and luteinizing hormone. So here the answer is option D, both A and B. Next question, missed abortion is also known as option A, complete abortion, option B, inevitable abortion, option C, silent miscarriage, option D, septic abortion. Missed abortion. A missed abortion is a non-viable intrauterine pregnancy that has been retained within the uterus without spontaneous abortion. Typically, no symptoms exist besides amenorrhea, and the patient finds out that the pregnancy stopped development earlier when a fetal heartbeat is not observed or heard at the appropriate time. So it is otherwise called as silent miscarriage. So here the answer is option C, silent miscarriage. Next question, axillary tail, Montgomery's tubercles or occur during the time of pregnancy because of the changes in option A, skin, option B, breast, option C, blood volume, option D, uterus. Montgomery tubercles, non-pigmented nodules around the areola in second month, that means enlarged sebaceous glands or rudimentary lactiferous ducts. Axillary tail of the breast is an extension of the tissue of the breast that extends into the axilla. So here the answer is option B, breast. Next question, identify correct statement regarding linear Niagara. Option A, brownish black pigmented area in the midline stretching from cisternum to symbiosis pubis. Option B, it is probably due to melanocyte stimulating hormone from anterior pituitary. Option C, pigmentation disappear after delivery. Option D, all the above. Linear Niagara, the pregnancy line officially called linear Niagara, is the dark line that develops across your belly during pregnancy. Melanocyte stimulating hormone created by the placenta is the main contributing factor. Usually lessens and fades away shortly after the birth of your baby. So here all the statements are correct. So here the answer is option D, all the above. Next question, what is the total weight gain occur during the course of singleton pregnancy? Option A, 5 to 7 kg. Option B, 7 to 9 kg. Option C, 10 to 12 kg. Option D, 12 to 14 kg. Expected weight gain during the singleton of pregnancy is 11 kg, in which 1 kg in first trimester, 5 kg each in second and third trimester. So here the answer is option C, 10 to 12 kg. Next question, ergometrine is useful for option A, eclampsia, option B, preeclampsia, option C, postpartum hemorrhage, option D, twin delivery. Clinical uses of ergometrine, prophylaxis and treatment of postpartum hemorrhage in normal labor and in cesarean section, treatment of bleeding in abortion, in puerperium if bleeding is heavy. So here the answer is option C, postpartum hemorrhage. Next question, fall in hematocrit value observed during pregnancy because option A, hemodilution, option B, hemoconcentration, option C, blood loss, option D, due to progesterone hormone. Physiological changes during pregnancy, plasma volume increase by 50%, red cell mass increase by up to 25%, there is consequent fall in hemoglobin concentration, hematocrit and red cell count because of hemodilution. Start from 6 to 8 weeks, this is maximum at 32 weeks of gestation. So here the answer is option A, hemodilution. Next question, after the delivery, insulin requirement of your diabetic mother will be option A, decrease significantly, option B, increase significantly, option C, no alteration, option D, insulin can be withdrawn. During the delivery process, most of the glucose will be consumed as part of metabolism for energy production, which significantly reduces the insulin requirement in postpartum period. So here the answer is option A, decrease significantly. Next question, lateral position is given to pregnant mothers in order to avoid option A, supine hypotension, option B, orthostatic hypotension, option C, aspiration, option D, promotes venous return. Lateral position is given to a mother to avoid supine hypotension or postural hypotension. Gravid uterus compresses inferior vena cava when the patient is in supine position and cause hypotension, tachycardia and syncope. This can be avoided by providing lateral position to the client. So here the answer is option A, supine hypotension. Next question, fourth stage of labor means option A, observation phase, option B, placenta delivering phase, option C, episiotomy given phase, option D, none of the above. Fourth stage, this is the period from the delivery of the afterbirth to the time when the woman is examined and then transferred to her room. This is the stage of observation for at least 1 to 2 hours after expulsion of the afterbirth. So here the answer is option A, observation phase. Next question, after ovulation, graafian follicle becomes option A, corpus luteum, option B, placenta, option C, umbilical cord, option D, amnion and chorion. Ovarian cycle, following ovulation, empty follicle under the influence of luteinizing hormone becomes a corpus luteum, which secretes progesterone and estradiol. Non-fertile cycle becomes corpus albicans. So here the answer is option A, corpus luteum. Next question, hormone human chorionic gonadotropin can be detected in case of option A, pregnancy, option B, hydatidiform mole, option C, choriocarcinoma, option D, all the above. Human chorionic gonadotropin is a glycoprotein hormone secreted by the developing placenta. In a normal pregnancy, HCG can be detected as early as 7 days following conception. At the time of the first missed menstrual period, HCG concentration is about 100 milli international unit per ml, reaching peak level at the end of the first trimester. HCG is an excellent marker for early detection of pregnancy. HCG can be detected in case of pregnancy, hydatidiform mole, choriocarcinoma. It will be disappeared from blood following 2 weeks after delivery. So here the answer is option D, all the above. Next question, endocrine control of lactation can be seen in option A, lactogenesis, option B, galactokinesis, option C, galactopoiesis, option D, all the above. Physiology of lactation. Lactation can be divided into 5 stages. 1. Mammogenesis, that means development of a breast to functional state. Second one is lactogenesis, that means synthesis and secretion of milk from breast alveoli. Third one is galactokinesis, that means ejection of milk outside the breast. Fourth one is galactopoiesis, that means maintenance of lactation. Fifth one is involution, that means regression and atrophy post lactation. So here the answer is option D, all the above. I hope you got understand. Thanks for watching.